Now that we have the closed caption importer plugin for QuickTime installed, we're able to export our project as a SCC file that we can put on our iPods, iPhones, or use for broadcasting. So when I export as a Sonic Sonorous SCC file, what's going to happen is MovieCaptioner is going to go through my whole project and it's going to check each line and make sure there's only 32 characters per line, and it'll put a line break in the word space after that somewhere. It'll make sure that there's no more than 4 lines per caption as well. It's best to not have line breaks in your project. Let MovieCaptioner do it for you. It'll all be automatic. So let's go ahead and export. It's going to take 2 passes to go through and check for line length and break it up as need be, and it's going to ask you to save it, and it's going to use an SCC extension. If you have hide extension unchecked, click save. It's going to import it into QuickTime, and we're going to see our captions.
Just before lunch one day, a puppet show was put on at school. It was called Mr. Bungle Goes to Lunch. It was fun to watch.
So that's how you add SCC captions. It's going to write a file on your, in this case on my desktop. It's the, this is what the SCC file looks like. It's just a bunch of binary numbers that represent the captions and some time code. And if you're using compressor, this is the file that you would import in the compressor or your DVD program. So that's how easy it is to do SCC captions with MovieCaptioner.